In this example, we want to look at the Schmitt trigger problem from the quiz 3 in the spring of 14. This is the Schmitt trigger configured using a 741 op amp. The philosophy we want to follow in solving problems is to always simplify. Try to find the simplest part of the problem that we can address and and focus on that rather than trying to do everything all at once. So the goal here is simplify. Okay, and in step one, what we want to do is we want to take a look at the configuration and make some decisions relatively quickly about it. And the first thing we'll notice is there is an operational amplifier, but there is no negative feedback. Okay, since there is no negative feedback, then the output of the output states, there can only be two output states. That is, when the voltage at the positive input right here exceeds that of the negative input, then the output state is going to be high. And in this case, we'll make the assumption that it will go to, so when V plus is greater than V minus, V out will equal 9 volts. Second case, when V plus is less than V minus, V out will equal minus 9 volts. Now, in reality, with the 741 op amp, the output voltage will be a little bit less. And so if when you solve a problem like this, if you decide to say it's going to be 8 volts or 8.2 volts or pick some number and explain that it doesn't quite get to the power supply voltages, that's fine. But generally, just keep it simple and just say the assumption is that it will go all the way to the output voltage and we work from that. So we have two possible states for the output. So V out is here. Okay, and then V plus and V minus are where the plus and minus inputs are. All right, the next simplification is we want to pay no attention whatsoever to the input, which is right here, and focus totally on the thresholds, the switching thresholds set by these, the voltage on the left, the reference voltage of the 2 volts, the two resistors, and the output voltage. All right, so what we want to do is I'll just redraw this really quickly and we'll be able to see how to do this quite simply. So looking at the basically just the top part of the circuit up here, we have 2 volts, the two resistors, and either 9 volts or minus 9 volts. So I've just redrawn them like this. And so the question is, what is the voltage here and here? So when the output voltage is high, that is when V plus is greater than V minus, the voltage there, V will be equal to 2 plus 9 minus 2 times 3 over 10. Because this is a voltage divider. The 3K and 7K are a voltage divider. And so 30% of the voltage from here to here will appear right there. So that becomes 2 plus 7 times 0.3, which is 4.1. Okay, so that's in the second case is V is equal to 2 plus minus 9 plus 2 times 0.3. Okay. Sorry, that was minus 9 minus 2. I just wrote the wrong thing down. So this becomes equal to 2 minus 11 times 0.3, or 2 minus 3.3, or minus 1.3. So we're going to have thresholds of minus 1.3 and plus 4.1. Okay, so if we go back to the diagrams that we had before, We have the two thresholds, which are going to be plus 4.1 and minus 1.3. All right, now we can pay attention to actually what these voltages are, because they're indicated in the diagram on the right. So now I put the two switching thresholds on the diagram at the upper right. And one thing to also make clear is that it doesn't actually matter too much what the actual input voltage is that's shown over here. It's the plot that's the easiest thing to look at. You know, so when we see the signal go below minus 1.3 volts, it's going to switch. When it goes above 4.1 volts, it's going to switch. And nothing else actually matters. I was sort of hoping I'd be able to draw this on here with my stylus, but unfortunately it's very hard to control to that kind of detail. So what I'm going to do then is to just move to the solution, which is shown here. You'll notice that let's just take this part of the signal right here. Here is the minus 1.3. And here's the plus 4.1 up at this level up here, 1.3 down here. So in this region, when this signal right here, the green signal, which is the input signal, when it passes through this point right here, at that point it drops below V minus. I'm sorry, the input comes in on the negative input, so that's when it drops below V plus. And at that point, then V minus is less than V plus. Under those circumstances, right at that point, the output switches up to the high voltage, which is 9 volts right here. And the reference voltage on the positive input now moves up to 4.1 volts. Continues to drop and then rises up, and then when it passes through 4.1, now the negative input exceeds the positive input, and it's the output switches to minus 9 volts, and the reference becomes minus 1.3, and the thing cycles again. So you get to this point again, and the signal jumps high, and you get to this point, and the signal jumps low. But the idea here was pay no attention largely to the input signal until you work out these two thresholds. Okay. Once you have those two thresholds, which you get from solving a simple voltage divider equation, under those circumstances, then you can immediately see where the two switching points are, and then you can check to see if the input voltage actually crosses those two levels. And indeed, in this case, it does. It goes up to above 5 volts and sufficiently low. It goes below the minus 1.3, so it goes almost to 4 volts, about 3.5 volts negative. So it passes both the plus 4.1 and the minus 1.3. If you put in a signal where it actually only crossed one of the thresholds, it would switch once and never switch again, because it has to go above this one and then below this one in order to be able to switch back and forth. So that's the simplification here. First of all, the very first part was there's no negative feedback. You can have only the two output states. So you just analyze the problem as if nothing exists except the voltage source V5, the two resistors, and Vout. Okay, which is what I set up over here, and got the two different voltage levels. I indicated the two voltage levels. I can see the input voltage crosses them. It actually doesn't in any way matter what it does. It only matters that it crosses those two thresholds. In between, it can wiggle all at once and do anything. It doesn't really matter. So focus on the things that matter and keep the decision process as simple as possible. And finally, in the end, you can see why the output does what it does. Because you get these two switching points, and indeed it does what you expect it to do. And you can go back and verify that indeed that the voltage on pin on the negative input is less than the voltage on the positive input when it's supposed to switch, and so forth. And that's this problem. And that's we'll go on to a couple of other examples of how to simplify things in preparation for the final quizzes of electronic instrumentation.